what the women out there should do to, you know, keep their mental peace going on, or if they have some kind of crisis in their life, whether it's a job crisis, because a lot of us are facing that. I mean, all these kind of crises, how do we deal with them?
So it's interesting, because for me, it always goes down to your mindset. And a lot of it looks at how are you framing your situation? How are you looking at your situation? Are you looking at it like a doomsday? Oh my gosh, poor me. The world is ending, and looking at it that way. Or can you reframe the way that you look at it and say, this whole crazy pandemic, like nobody, like the carpet was sort of pulled underneath the entire world at the same time. It is a lot going on, but can you look at it and say, okay, amongst all this chaos, it's also an opportunity for a pause. It's an opportunity for me to get to know me even more. It's an opportunity where, yeah, a lot of stuff is actually coming up. There's a lot of resistance and a lot of emotional things that people are actually, because we're not busy anymore, but you're actually giving yourself the time and space to be able to feel it. And that is so powerful. So I think, like, I always say the most important relationship you have is the one looking in the mirror.
Is absolutely.
So what could you do to strengthen the relationship with you in this time? What can you do to really, like, look in the mirror and love the person that is looking back to you a little bit more? And I mean, there's so many different tools and things that you can pull on depending on, you know, how you feel, and different techniques to process different emotions. Because I think it's important to honor, if you feel anxious, if you feel angry, if you feel scared, the worst thing you can do is actually push those emotions away and just put a smile on your face. And I feel like in society, that's a lot of times what we've been doing, you know, like, just put a smile on your face. Hey, I'm good. Are you good? I'm good. I'm good. It's like, did you even really have a conversation in that exchange? Whereas now it's like space to actually look at the feelings that were probably inside of you even before all of this, and process and release and let go, and make your life better. It's an opportunity.
I think, you know, one should discuss with your, you know, friends, your partner, whoever it is, because like you said, a lot of time, a lot of us, we just don't discuss our feelings, particularly if we are hurt or something. I think emotions are absolutely okay. The way we share our happiness, similarly, the grief or any kind of sadness should be shared as well. Because
all of them.
Yes, absolutely.